Hey guys, David here with a slightly different video today because there hasn't really been any 3DS or Wii 2 news or anything like that. So I thought I'd just have a slightly one-sided discussion about something I've been mentioning in recent videos, which is the whole hardcore versus casual gaming debate. So I've mentioned a few times that Nintendo intends to recapture the hardcore market, or supposedly according to the rumours. But every time I mention those words hardcore and casual, people get a bit annoyed. And in general, I would agree that hardcore and casual, like the difference between those, is pretty meaningless. It's really just a pretentious label to place yourself above someone else. But it is sort of easier to use those words, hardcore and casual, to convey that Nintendo wants to go after the more dedicated gamer. Which in itself is really just another way to say hardcore, and once again can just be a cause for pretension. But both words are pretty useful for conveying a few different ideas, and I just thought I'd run through how I interpret both of them. So when I mention hardcore, casual in the future, then you can remember this video and just understand where I'm coming from. Because it's not like I want to keep pushing the idea that there is a hardcore and a casual gamer, and that these hardcore gamers are better than casual gamers, or maybe even vice versa. And hopefully this video can help you understand what I am actually saying. So I think I'll start off with an example. I think the easiest comparison to make between hardcore and casual gaming is someone who likes movies and someone who is a movie buff. So someone who's a movie buff, someone who just loves movies, they'll know when the new releases are coming out, they'll know who directs it, they'll know all the nitty-gritty details behind the movie. While someone who just likes movies, they might know the big releases, you know, like new Pirates of the Caribbean or new Harry Potter movie or something like that. But they're not tracking it for months. They might see a trailer a couple months before it comes out, but nothing more than that. And that's what I feel like the distinction between hardcore and casual is. The hardcore gamer is following the blogs and participating in forums and really tracking the games they care about. They're the people who like watch these videos or watch any videos about games. Because it's important to remember that you are a part of the small percentage that do track games as much as you do. Even if this is the first video you've ever seen and the last video you ever watch about games, that's still more than a lot of people do. There is a huge segment of the market, they see a new Mario game or they see a new Grand Theft Auto game, and they just buy that. They see the marketing on TV, they hear their friends talking about it a bit, and they buy it. So I think a lot of the confusion revolves around the fact that people label themselves as a hardcore gamer just because they have an Xbox, or just because they play Call of Duty, or just because they play any other specific game. But I don't see it as a specific game making you hardcore, and it's not necessarily a single game that makes you a casual gamer either. Like, I play a bit of Call of Duty, I've played some Angry Birds, I've been on both sides of that fence. Which basically means, by that definition, that if you play a certain game, you're a certain type of gamer, then I should be split in two. And in fact, on that note, you know, Call of Duty is one of the most casual games you can actually buy. It's that perfect example of plenty of people just buy Call of Duty every year. And that's fine, like, I got nothing against the game. Like I said, I do actually play it. And I enjoy it and all that, but it doesn't change the fact that it is one of those few games that those casual gamers would buy. Simply because it is getting the marketing, it is getting that push, and lots of people's friends do have it. So I'm sort of rambling here, I'm not sure if I'm totally making sense. But whenever I say hardcore or casual gamer, I'm not talking about what games people play. There's no single game or experience that'll make you one or the other. It's how interested you are in the industry and in that form of entertainment. Another way of saying it might be that casual gamers just see gaming as another form of entertainment. They place it just alongside movies and books and TV and all these other forms of media. Whereas a gamer doesn't see gaming as just another form of entertainment. It's like a part of their life. They've integrated it purposefully in some way. Doesn't necessarily mean you're like a professional gamer or anything like that, but you actively go out and try to make it a part of your life. You might have friends that are gamers, you might participate in forums, you might do that kind of thing. And there's just that decreased separation between you and gaming. It sounds sort of cheesy, but it sort of becomes like a part of you. Anyways, like I said, I'm probably just rambling. I'm not too sure what I'm saying. I didn't actually write down an argument or anything like that. But at the end of the day, it's not a matter of people who have Nintendo consoles not being hardcore gamers. I think that's where like a lot of the animosity comes from. People stupidly say that, oh, if you have a Nintendo console, you're not a hardcore gamer. But that's not the real issue. The mistake people make is that people believe that if you buy a Nintendo console, you're a casual gamer, rather than if you're a casual gamer, you buy a Nintendo console. Those two statements sound very similar, but they are very different. I'd very much consider someone a hardcore gamer if they buy a new Super Mario Brothers or Super Mario Galaxy or whatever. Those sort of experiences attract casual gamers, but if you're actively looking forward to those games and you read about them online before they come out and that kind of thing, then you are really dedicated. And that's the real difference, I think, is that dedication to gaming and that integration with everything you do. Gaming might not dominate your life, but you've at least deemed it worthy of being a part of your life in some respect, beyond just playing the occasional game or dabbling with a certain game every now and then. But yeah, I'm getting way off track now. I have even no idea what I've just said, so hopefully I can edit it together in some coherent story. But I want to hear your thoughts though. What do you consider to be a hardcore or casual gamer? What do you think is the difference? And if you're firmly on the side of hardcore and casual gaming as a concept is ridiculous, then just try to think about the other side of the fence. And in that same respect, if you're someone who goes, Call of Duty is hardcore and Mario is, you know, casual, then think about that from the other side of the fence. Just dabble in someone else's perspective and try to understand where they might be coming from. Because I really think it's a matter of the middle way always being the right way. there's not going to be an extreme of what hardcore casual gaming is. You find that balance between these two sides that have these completely different ideas and try to bring them together, which is what I've tried to do. But yep, that's it. Back to regular videos, probably tomorrow. I'm assuming there's going to be some more 3DS or Wii 2 news at some point in the near future. But I just wanted to share my thoughts, and for now, I will talk to you later.